computer updated.
Oh, thanks, computer, for updating yourself, because that's not really annoying when you repeat yourself over that over and over again like you just did then. This is 1997's Quake 2. Computer's updated by id Software. Yeah, Quake 2. Look at the light sourcing. It was one of the first games to sort of do this. I was so impressed. I never really played Quake 1 a lot, you know. I dabbled in it. But for some reason, Quake 2 was the one where I really, really started to like love Quake. But back then, when I was, I was 7, 97, 16, I was probably about 14, 15 when this game came out. Pretty much a good age, you know, aggressive game, you know, noise, guns. But I never really realised until now, but it's just really, really dark. Obviously it's dark because it's a Quake game, id Software, you know, they do their moody shit, but it's just like, I don't know if it's because they wanted to shove the light in more, or what, but like, it's very muted colours, you know, sort of like, you know, it's trying to be red, but it's brown, it's, you know, it's trying to be green, but it's sort of grey, and I think it is just to show off their lighting colour, like, it's, ooh, look at the light go down the dark corridor, ooh, look at the light go down the big room, yeah, it's just, but this game, I did enjoy, for stuff like that. It was kind of like, you know, games could get away with it back then because they had new features like when he dies, he's not really going to die because he'll trick you and then he'll try and kill you and you're like, wow, that's amazing. Oh, I forgot about this gun. It's the SMG. Oh, the kickback on that. You'd think if you were like some sort of soldier, yeah, you'd like, you'd think you'd learn how to handle a machine gun better than that. So yeah, obviously the follow-up to Quake and it was much loved. The multiplayer was a big thing for me as well with this. I seem to remember playing a lot of mods. Action, I guess Action Quake was on this, but I might be wrong with that. Can't really remember where I played the Action Quake and stuff like that, which is obviously the precursor to Action Half-Life, if anyone's played that. And yeah, I think, I'm saying think a lot really, because I can't really remember. I think Half-Life runs on a Quake 2 engine, which sort of makes sense, because it sort of looks a bit like Half-Life 1. You know, like, just by looking at that bit there, you could sort of imagine Gordon Freeman in a sewer-ish area. So yeah, I mean, this is literally the start of the game. Played it for like 2 minutes, and then I'm already here. And already I'm starting to remember, like, things. Just like, oh my god, I can't believe I can remember that after all these years. It's amazing what your memory can retain. I remember these big guys here with the Gatling guns for arms, pretty much like the guy from Final Fantasy VII. What's his name? I don't know. I've forgotten his name. What's his name? I wasn't a Final Fantasy fan. Yeah! I found a secret area. Shotgun. Can we get the shotgun. Yeah, mainly Quake is all about the shotgun for me. You know, the tactile feeling of Doom and Quake shotguns are essential to enjoying the game. All the other guns are like, you know, they're there if they work, and they use them when you run out of shotgun shells. Like, they could just call this game the shotgun game, and maybe the double barrel shotgun game. Open this sewer. Oh, makes a noise. I can go in there. 3D gaming. Oh, loading. Let's check our computer, because the computer is updated. Comm sensor. Established communication link to command ship. Okay, communication center. You know, it's just things like this, like, you know, the coloured corridors. I seem to remember enjoying this version. I mean, the N64 version of this, because it had split-screen multiplayer, and there was much fun to be had there. But that came out in, like, 1999, so a couple of years after. And I think it looked a bit better than this. I mean, this is running on today's sort of PC. So, oh, no, I forgot about these! Oh, these used to scare me. Oh, what is that? Some weird laser beam, or is it a tongue? I can't really work it out. And, you know, it'd be fair to say that this is the last great Quake game that had single player. You know, Quake 4? Bit of a turd. Not gonna lie, it could have been called Doom 3.1. Because it was just literally just Doom 3. Not literally, that's a bit of a... Oh, here we go! Oh. What? Why do I do that? Oh my god, activate, you know, what do you mean? Yeah, here we go, Quake damage, hit the Q button. Man, I'm wrecking things here. Yeah, boom! What the hell is that? Yeah, you're dead. remember those guys with the Gatling guns having that hideous animation where you shot their head off, like it just literally disappeared. I'm saying the word literally today quite a lot. I wonder why. So yeah, ooh, it's Quake Week. Hang on, it's Software Week on Kane and Rinse's YouTube channel. I don't know what spurred that, but it kind of meant that I had to do these quick rinses. But never mind, I love going back and playing the games that I used to love and realising they're not as good as what I remember, which is this one. You know, games have moved on. I think Doom holds up better than this, and maybe because, you know, this isn't trying out 3D tech seriously for the first time, so it's all about the flash. Graphics. You know, it was, like I said, it's about stuff like that and the sort of similar bollards. Yeah, and you know, I even think Quake 1's better than this in retrospect. Like, you know, playing Quake 1 again recently for that quick rinse, I think Quake 1 has a bit more of a personality to it. Even if it is like, you know, gothics or the 9-inch nails stuff everywhere. This game had many expansion packs, sort of like, I was going to start reeling off a list of names, something like Ground Zero and, you know, the typical army terms, like Squad Command, Team Action, SWAT Command Control, Quake. And yeah, you know, this is sort of like id Software's last IP before Rage, you know, like they, you know, they like their one word names. Oh. Doom, Rage, Quake. What if they come up with a game called Pontefract Over the Balloon Swab? Do you reckon people would look like that? Do you reckon? Oh, we've got the blue key. And it's this kind of era that I did love. It sort of sticks out for me as a golden moment for gaming, you know, the discovering 3D-ness of video games. This and Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight seem to be a particular favourite of mine. You are fucking joking me. Oh well, let's not grab that. Let's go down here. Uh-oh. I love... Oh, you... Oh, Jesus. There was no need for that. Although, I sort of predicted a bit. Look at the animation! He untwists a grenade! That's amazing! Technology. You know, and I can see why people don't like these kind of games where you have to like run around a sort of a quasi sandbox mode. Out of item, quad damage. Out of item, environmental suit. See, say like that. Yeah, I'm gonna say stuff to myself. Hello, world. The hell are you chatting about? How do I use my scuba? You know, yeah, like I was saying, but I can see why people don't like running around these sort of non-linear environments looking for blue doors. You know, it's not the most fun to be had. Aha, rebreather. B. Because you can often find yourself frustrated and lost. And, you know, I'm wondering, is this game got a map? Because I know Doom had a map. Has got a map.
He's got a map here, he's doing. Is he? Is Quake? No, I don't think so.
Oh, hello, this must be the... And you know you're going the right way because you'll see enemies that you haven't seen before, or just enemies. You're like, oh, okay, yeah, this must be the right way because there are enemies there. Oh, now let's pop his head off. Go on, pop your head off. Aw, oh, jibs. I don't know if Soldier Fortune was out or before this game, but Jibs were the thing, man. Like, you could like chop his arm off or something. Is it Gibbs? Jibs? No one knows. It's like GIFs and GIFs. Who gives a flying fuck? Installation.
No, I've already done that. That's why I'm playing it. Her, not installing it. Ha. I made a joke about installing stuff.
Now, that is a knob. Look at that. That is much bigger than me. It's not. I'm bigger than that. Right, if I change my remote gun, I'll shoot his head off. Because I've got to end this quick rinse with his head popping off. Come here, come on, come on, come here. Oh, that's like groundbreaking gameplay there. I lured him in to the explosive barrel. Never seen anything like that before. That was a world first for Kanoids. Not for YouTube, just for Kanoids. I used an explosive barrel. Boom shakalaka. Fuck off. Right, here we go. Shoot your head off, shoot your head off. There you— Where's your head come? Where's your head at? Teabag him. I would teabag him, but he hasn't got a head. That is one of two crucial elements for the teabag. A bag and a head. Right then. This looks like— oh Jesus, remember him? Has he got a sword in his left arm? I can't remember. I seem to remember some sort of— oh no, grenade launcher, that's it. As he pumps grenades. Or his twin does anyway. G? Yeah, here we go. I think you're fine, mate. Grenades are better than launched ones. What? Right, so thanks for watching. This has been a Quake rinse. I've got a Quake 2. I'll see you in the Quake 3-ness. Yeah? Yeah. Uh-huh.